Hey, how's it going? David Taub here with Epic Guitar Instruction. Hope all's going well, and I hope your guitar and musical journeys are going famously. Today we're going to do a one guitar solo acoustic version of the Elton John song 60 Years On. Now this song first appeared on his second studio record entitled Elton John, and that was from 1970. And we're going to do the song in its original key, which is the key of B minor. And we are at standard A440 tuning. So go ahead and tune your guitars low to high. E, A, D, G, B, and E. The song is in the key of B minor, and it's in 4-4 time. It's a really fun song to play, and I have this arranged to work for one guitar. Now, obviously, this song is very huge. There's a lot of orchestration. It's like a symphony, almost, what's going on. There's so much happening. So we're going to simplify it a little bit. First, let's go over all the chords in the song, because there's quite a few variations on a B minor chord that he's playing. So first of all, you have a B minor bar chord here. Now, if you also, at times, he adds that F sharp in the bass, so you could bar your finger over that sixth string also, and you get this B minor over F sharp chord. If you don't want to play that one, you could just play the B minor chord at the times. I'll show you where in the progression. Also, if you play the B minor and you take your pinky off, that's a B minor seventh. You're going to need that. Also, if you go back to B minor and take off your second finger, but don't bar it, hook your first finger on that second fret of the A string, right? So you have open high E, open B. That's actually like a B sus 4 chord. Now, if you leave the third and fourth fingers there and you bar that, right? So now I'm barring it, that's a B sus 2 chord. All chords that you're going to hit in this song. You're also going to need A major, E major, G major, F sharp bar chord, and if you take off your pinky, that's an F sharp seventh, dominant seventh chord, which you'll need, and also E minor. And if you're having trouble with those bar chords or going from bar chords to open chords, I could really help you with that. Click on the link in the YouTube description box below, and I'll send you a killer free video lesson and ebook. The video lesson's not on YouTube, it's extended play, and it's my best bar chord playing tips and changing tips. It's packed with technique tips and exercises that'll just blast your bar chord playing and changing to the next level. And I also pair that with an ebook, and in the ebook there's more chord charts, more lessons, more exercises. It's a killer 1-2 punch. Get both of them for free by clicking below. Now, song structure wise, there's not a lot of different parts to this song in this arrangement. It's a lot of repeating the same kind of progression. So basically, the song starts with the intro, which will do the progression 4 times. If you're playing it solo acoustic guitar, you might just want to do it twice because it's kind of repetitive to do it that many times, but your choice. That goes right into verse 1, who'll walk me down the church when I'm 60 years of age. Verse 1 then goes into, you repeat the intro again 1 time. The chords change a little bit, which I'll show you. That goes into verse 2, you hung up your greatcoat and you've laid down your gun. It's exact same progression as verse 1. That goes into another intro repeat. On the original version, it's long. It's like 4 times. I would, again, just do it once or twice. And that goes into verse 3. Yes, I'll sit here with you and talk. Let your eyes relieve again. And verse 3 is very similar to verse 1 and 2, where it's basically the same thing, and then he adds 2 more vocal lines on it. Basically the same progression, and the song ends on a B minor chord, which I'll show you. So let's start with the intro. Now, obviously, the original version, it's very, very long, and there's a lot going on as far as instrumentation on the studio version and the orchestration with the symphony and everything. So what I did was I stripped it down, and I'm going to show you a way that you can arpeggiate the progression and the chords, and it really kind of captures the vibe of the intro. Now, the intro progression he plays 4 times around. I'm just going to do it once for brevity's sake because it's long. Like I said earlier, when you're playing it, you might only want to do it twice. Up to you, but let me play you the intro in this version. It'll sound like this. Starts over. And you do it 3 more times, so it's 4 times around in total. So the intro progression, you're going to play that B minor chord twice. I'll show you the picking pattern. Then you're going to go to an A major twice, E major once. Then you're going to play that B sus 4 1 time. And then you're going to do the B minor twice. That's 8 measures total. Then you repeat that whole thing three more times. Okay, so here's the picking pattern that kind of captures the vibe. And you could pick all these chords in the same way. And you let the notes ring out throughout. So hold your B minor chord and you pick the A string, then B, G, D. Just go right up the strings. Okay, and it's an eighth note. So you just count it one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Okay, straight eighth note picking pattern. So you pick the A string, then pick the B string, G string, D string, then go down high E, B, G, D. So here's the pattern slow. Repeat. Okay, and again, you could count it one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Notice the notes are ringing into each other. You're not letting them cut off, right? Then you go to the A major chord. So you do the B minor two times through. A major, same thing. Right? So you pick that A string, the open A, then B, G, D, high E, B, G, D. Now, when you go to the E chord, you hit the low E, finger your E major, hit the low E, or the low E and the A, doesn't matter. It, you know, doesn't have to be exact. And then you're going to pick B, G, D, high E, B, G, D. But you just do it once on the E, B minor, and A, you do it twice. Then you go to the B sus 4 chord, same pattern. Once, and then back to B minor. Twice, and it starts over again. And that's just a nice version that you could do that really kind of captures the vibe of the intro of the song. So after that intro, you go right into verse one, who walked me down to church when I'm 60 years of age. And then what I would do is start strumming. And if you have a second, please subscribe to the channel. You know, that's really important. It really helps us to keep bringing the content. And ring that subscription bell, because then you'll be notified when I have new lessons posted. Also, leave me a comment below. Let me know how you like this lesson. Let me know what lessons you'd like to see coming up. And if you like the video, please click the like button. Give it a thumbs up, share it, and thank you so much for your support. Now, there's three verses in the song, first and second, exactly the same. Third, exactly the same, just a little longer. Let me play you verse one and two. It'll sound like this. Goes right back into the intro progression, which we'll get into in a minute, and that's the verse. All right, so here's the chords with the vocal line. B minor over F sharp. Who'll walk me A down to church. I'll show you the strum pattern in a minute. When I'm 60, on 60 you go to G, years of age. B minor over F sharp on age. When the ragged, on ragged E minor, dog they gave me has been 10, F sharp 7th, years in the grave. And by the way, on that E minor and on that F sharp, you're going to stay on that chord twice as long. Two measures. And then Senorita B minor and Senorita play on play. You go to A, guitar, G, play it just for you, B minor over F sharp. My rosary, E minor for twice as broken. And my beads, this time F sharp 7 just once, have all slipped through. Then you go to B minor because you're going to do that variation of the intro progression, okay? The strum pattern, what works nice for this is just do a simple down, 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 up. That's a nice pattern. You can do it for all the chords in the song. Down, 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 up. So it's down, rest, down, down, up, down, rest, down, down, up. Get that down. No pun intended. Down, 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 up, down, down, down. That's the verses. Same verse for verse 1 and 2. I'll show you verse 3 at the end. So at the end of verse 1, you're ending on that B minor, and you go right back in and repeat the intro with a little variation. Now, you could strum it, or you could pick it. Your choice. Let me play it for you picked. It'll sound like this. Now, it's a little different progression. Let me play it for you, and I'll go back and explain it. Sound like this. up. We're into verse 2. All right, so this time the progression, very similar. B minor twice, A twice, E once. Then you go to a B minor 7th. Okay, it's just a little bit different. You play that B minor 7th instead of playing the B sus 4. And then after the B minor 7th, you're going to go to a B suspended 2nd twice. Okay, and then it goes right from there into verse 2. Now, if you prefer to strum that part, you could use the same pattern we did in the verses. If you prefer it that way, it'll sound like this. Second verse. So you have some options there. You know, if you like doing the picking thing, it kind of breaks it up. So you're going from picking, strumming, or you could strum it if you're feeling that vibe. That's a great thing about guitar, right? All these wonderful choices. That intro goes right back into after the B sus 2 twice. You start B minor, you hung up your great coat right into verse 2, exactly the same as verse 1. That goes into another repeat of the intro between verse 2 and verse 3. Now, in the original recording, he plays a very long little interlude there. I would just do that intro again. You could do it twice, maybe just do it once this first time after verse 1, maybe do it twice there. And it's the same thing with the B minor 7th to the B sus 2, that version. That goes right into verse 3. So verse 3 is, yes, I'll sit with you and talk, let your eyes relive again. It's the same exact thing as verses 1 and 2, except one change. At the end, where you would end on that F sharp 7th, right? That line is your choral lamp that burns so low when you are passing through. Now, what you do there is you're going to repeat two vocal lines, and the future you're giving me holds nothing for a gun. I've no wish to be living 60 years on. The song ends. So he adds two vocal lines. Those lines, all you do, same progression. It's B minor, and the future you're giving A, me holds G, nothing for a gun. B minor or F sharp. E minor twice, I have no wish to be living. End of the song, 60 years on. And the song ends on B minor. Just let it ring. Okay, you could do like a little arpeggiation of the B minor chord if you want. And then just hit it once more, let it ring. Song ends, and that is 60 years on. A really fun one to play. It'll really work your bar chord playing and changing, maybe get you playing some new chords and arpeggiating and strumming together and whatnot. So enjoy that one, have fun with it. Remember, subscribe to the channel. That really helps us to keep bringing the content, and ring that subscription bell, and then you'll be notified when I have new lessons posted. Also, don't forget to click on the link below in the YouTube description box, get my free video lesson and ebook on bar chord techniques and bar chord changing techniques and bar chord exercises. It's killer. I think you'll really enjoy it. Thank you so much for watching. Keep up all that hard work on those guitars. And remember, your guitar playing is an evolution. So enjoy the journey. Take care, rock on. See you in the next lesson.